Hello everyone, welcome to another Godot tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make your animated sprite customizable. The first thing to do is split the sprite into different parts. If you are making your own art, then it's best to have it in different layers in the first place. However, if you got your asset from a third party, you'll have to do the splitting manually. Using this open source asset as example, the character sprite is split into four parts: eye, head, body, and outline. I'm using a sprite to do this, but you can use any modern image editor. They should have similar features. Alright, first, use the magic wand tool to select the head parts. Ctrl C to copy, then create a new layer, and Ctrl V to paste. Repeat for the body, eyes, and the outline. By the way, if some of the parts have unique colors, you can untick the continuous option and a sprite will select all the pixels with the same colors. So now, you should have the parts split up in different layers. The next thing to do is convert them to white or grayscale using the paint bucket tool. You can skip this step, but if so, the sprite will have a hue from its original color when we try to customize them later on. Next, export them individually. In the export dialog, select a layer, name it accordingly, click export, and repeat it for the other layers. In the Godot editor, using a node2d as the root node, add a sprite2d node to it, name it head, set the texture to the head part we exported just now, and set the H frames and B frames. In this case, it's 4 and 4. Repeat this step for the body, eyes, and outline. To change the color of each part, you just have to change the self-modulate color. You can also change this property in the script. Another way to customize the character is updating the texture. For example, you can change the shape of the head by swapping the texture. We are now to animate the character, add an animation player node to the root node2D. Then, create a new animation. Add a track. Select the frame property of the body sprite node. Then, add the keys to the track. Cool. Now the body is animating. We just have to do the same thing for the other sprite parts. Wait, do you see a problem here? In my game, the cat sprite has 7 parts and 22 animations. That means I need to repeat the task 154 times. I don't have time for that. So as a programmer, I wrote some code to automate the process. And to contribute back to the Godot community, I compiled all my work here into a Godot plugin. All you need to do is download it from my GitHub or from the asset library. Once you have the plugin installed, select the root node2D. A new tab will appear on your right panel. Click on it, select the library, check or uncheck which node you want to be animated. In this case, all of them. Here, you can add new animation to the list. For example, walk down, looping from frame 0 to frame 3, and click generate. Cool, the character can now animate the walking down action. We can then add the rest of the animation using the plugin. Oh, by the way, here's a tip. If you're not sure which frame number you should use for the animation, create a new sprite frame, select it, then in the bottom panel, click on this grid button, select one of your sprite sheets, and adjust the grid size. On the top, click select all. As you can see, Godot will mark the index of each frame for us. Take a screenshot for reference, and you can delete the sprite frame now. Alright, that's all for this video. If you find it helpful, don't forget to leave a like on the video, and please consider subscribing for more game dev tutorial and contents. I'm Boon, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.